Word and character slices are director-only features that allow you to animate individual words and letters in a text layer. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create this character slice title slide. First, add a one or two word text layer. For this example, I'm going to use all capital letters. To create animations using either word or character slices, you won't animate this main text layer. You'll open this layer and then animate the words or character slice layer. There's no need to animate each word or each character individually. You'll tell Photopia to do that using the animation timing settings. So let's get started with something pretty simple, just to see how this works. We're going to select the character slice layer and go into the animations tab. Leave the position of the keyframes at the ends of the timeline. The timing will be adjusted in the slices tab, not here. But we will animate the position of this layer to start off screen on the first keyframe and then center screen on the second keyframe. If you play this back, it does exactly what you'd expect. It slowly animates the entire word, panning up onto the screen. Now we'll go back into the Slices tab. We'll open the animation timing settings and change the order from simultaneous to left to right. And change the end offset so that it ends before our slide time ends. Now when we play it back, each character comes on screen from left to right, and it ends before the slide ends. Now this looks a bit choppy, but with word and character slices, you have all the same animation tools that you do for layers. So we'll go back into the Animations tab and change the Position Easing mode to decelerate on that first keyframe so that the letters will ease into place. We can also add a 10% overlap to the animation timing, which means that each letter will start its animation when the previous letter is 90% finished, creating a slight overlap. And that's the basic technique for creating word or character animations. Animate the word or character slices as a whole unit, then set the slice animation timing to animate the characters or words from left to right, right to left, or randomly. Now let's recreate that original animation. The position wasn't animated in that title, so we'll remove that by clicking on the trash can icons in the Adjustments tab. In the Animations tab, change the first keyframe zoom to start at 300. Then change the horizontal tilt to start at 360. Finally, change the opacity to start at 0. And this is what it will look like. The original animation also had its first and last characters slightly larger. After everything is animated, go into the character slices, select the first character, increase its zoom, and then adjust its position as needed. Then repeat those steps for the last character. Character and word slices can be animated in nearly any way that a layer can, giving you infinite possibilities.